Hello, Senior Stoner fans. It's the real Senior Stoner back at you for your Puff Go Peak Pro Dab of the Day. Today is Wednesday. Hello, everybody. Well, I've been doing a lot of research in my evenings because we're coming up on the holidays. Let's say Christmas to New Year period. And traditionally, it's a very difficult period for people in pain, people alone, because frankly, the holidays bring up stress and depression. It just does. So we need to discuss it. When stress is at its peak, it's hard to stop it and regroup. So we must try to prevent stress and depression in the first place, especially if the holidays have taken an emotional toll on you in the past. You all know who you are. I'm one of them. We know the issues we have historically, having gone to people's homes during the holidays. Well, this year, it's different, and it's probably going to be worse for the people that feel this way. First thing we need to do is acknowledge our feelings. If you've had loss, if you're grieving, you must realize it's normal to be sad and grieve. It's okay to take time to cry and express your feelings even, because you just can't force yourself to be happy because it's the holiday season. So you got to be honest with yourself. That's number one. Number two. If you feel lonely or isolated, try to reach out. Seek community, religious, social events, community events, online, anything you can, support groups, social media sites, because they can offer support and a feeling of companionship, even though you're not really with someone. If you have friends and family, talk to them about this. Reach out with a text. Do a video chat. It's important for you to lift your spirits, but you can also lift your spirits by lifting others' spirits. If you wanted to volunteer your time on the phone, volunteer your time online, maybe dropping off a meal or some extra food you have at a food bank. These are things that can make you feel better. You also need to be realistic because the holidays, frankly, aren't going to be perfect and they're not going to be like last year. Families have changed. They've grown. All the procedures for families getting together have changed. Traditions, rituals, all that stuff has changed as well. So what we need to do when we're home by ourselves is choose a few of these things to hold on to and maybe create a few new ones. Think about it. If you used to have adult children or relatives come to your home and now they can't, find new ways of celebrating together. Share pictures online. Share emails. Share video. Meet virtually on a video call. Even though your plans are going to look different this year, you can find ways to celebrate. Set aside the differences. I have goose pimples on this one. We've got to try to accept family members and friends as they are, even if they don't live up to your expectations. Let's say it this way. They're not going to live up to your expectations. But you still have to set aside grievances until there's a more appropriate time for discussion. Not now. And be understanding of those that get upset or distressed when something goes a different way for them. The chances are they too are feeling the effects of holiday stress and depression. We don't often talk about this, but now, the way things are in the world, the holidays coming upon us, stick to a budget. Before you do your gift and food shopping, decide how much you can afford. Things have changed. Stick to your budget. Don't try to buy happiness with gifts. Think about it. Try to plan ahead. Try to set aside specific days if you have to shop physically, specific days for your baking, for connecting with friends, and other activities. Try to shop online as much as you can and plan your menus. This will help prevent your last-minute scrambling that we've all done to buy the forgotten ingredients, the forgotten things, because think about it. People are going to start to line up when it gets closer. Learn to say no. Think about this one. Saying yes when you should say no can leave a person feeling resentful and overwhelmed. Friends, colleagues, family members are going to understand if you can't participate in some projects or activities. If it's not possible to say no, when a boss asks you to work overtime, for example, try to remove something else from your agenda so you won't have to make up for lost time. It's a give-and-take world right now, more than ever before. And you have to remember that you've already, I'm 63, knock wood, I've made it this far. So don't abandon your healthy habits. Don't let the holidays become a free-for-all this year, because we know from history that overindulgence only adds to stress and guilt. Maybe snacking a little bit before the big meal. Try to eat healthier meals. Try to sleep as much as you can. Try to get some walking or activity in. Try breathing, meditation, yoga. I would naturally say this, but I know who I'm talking to. Avoid drug use, avoid tobacco and alcohol. Because those things, if used in the wrong ways, can send you down a dark path. Take a breather, senior stoner. That's right. Make time for yourself. Find something you enjoy. Take a break by yourself. Spend at least 15 minutes doing it without distractions. Because you know what? That little bit of time by yourself, refreshed, may help you get enough energy to handle everything you need to do. And to do that, you got to find something that reduces stress by clearing your mind, slowing your breathing, and restoring calm. Some of the things you might think about doing are nighttime walk and looking up at the stars. I like to look out at the stars at night in our backyard. Listening to very soothing music also helps. Maybe you can curl up with a wonderful good book. And lastly, of course, unfortunately, if you have to, seek professional help. Because despite yours, mine, everybody's best efforts, you may find yourself persistently sad, anxious, or plagued by physical complaints, unable to sleep, irritable, hopeless, and not even able to do routine chores. If those feelings last for a while, find a phone, call your doctor, call your mental health professional. Do not try to foot them alone. But the most important thing, I think, out of all these little suggestions is take control of the holidays. Don't let the holidays this year become something that you're going to dread. Instead, try to take some steps to prevent the stress, prevent the depression that can come on to us during the holidays. If we recognize our triggers, holiday triggers, such as financial pressures, personal demands, you may be able to combat them before you melt down. With a little bit of planning and some positive thinking, we all can find peace and some joy during the holidays. These are very, very important things, because without control during the holidays, we're going to be the whirling dervish. We're going to be spinning all over the place. I remember when our kids were young, we had to divide our time on the holidays between Mrs. Stoner's parents and my family. It's the same thing for our kids. They have to divide their time between our house and my in-law's house. That's how it goes. So guess what? If you control it instead of letting it control you, you may have a smoother holiday. It's going to be a difficult Christmas and a difficult New Year's for a lot of us. You can make it just a little bit better with a little bit of control, a little bit of planning. Today we're going to have green crack sativa dab. I'm going to share it with you in a moment here. And want to thank everyone for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. Send me your comments, please. I like them. and I respond to every one of them. It's incredibly important as we get to the holidays this year that even though there's sadness, there's grief, we need to be thankful, grateful, praying, thank you, that we are still here, that we are still able to do these videos, that you are able to watch these videos. Give yourself a pat on the back because you've made it this far. Let's not mess it up. Let's take it over the finish line and let's get through this holiday season. Cheers, everybody. And thanks for watching. Take control during the holidays. The Real Senior Stoner. Cheers.